Right, put it round here. Put it down there. Right round here. Right, leave it there. That's marvellous. All right here, Governor.
What the devil do you think you're doing?
Well, we just brought some old junk in.
Well, I can see you brought some old junk in, but what the devil do you mean by bringing it into the post office?
Well, one of your postmen put a pamphlet in my door this morning. It said, old junk wanted, highest prices, so we've had to sort out and brought it to you. Just wondered how much you give us for it.
How much we'll give you for this? My good man, this is the post office. It's not a rag and bone yard.
Well, one of your blokes put the bill through my door, mate. One of your postmen, so I thought it was you that was collecting it.
Yes, well, one of our postmen may have delivered this pamphlet, but if you had bothered to read it, you would have seen a sender's name and address down there. Now, it is they who want your junk, not us.
Well, I thought as it was you that was delivering the pamphlets, I thought you might be acting as agents for them.
Acting as agents?
Yeah.
Okay, I've obviously got to explain something to you. All the post office is doing now is to deliver everyone's pamphlets.
Oh, you deliver everybody's pamphlets, do you?
That's right, everyone's pamphlets, yes.
Do you deliver the Throttle and Soft pamphlet?
Well, yes, I suppose so.
Well, where's mine, then?
I beg your pardon?
I said, where's mine? I haven't had one this week. I've been left out, mate.
Oh, well, I couldn't care less.
Oh, you couldn't care less?
No.
Well, let me tell you something, mate. If it's your responsibility to deliver pamphlets, mate, especially the Throttle and Soft, you want to do it, mate. Because I'm the only one down the road who hasn't had one this week, mate.
Yeah.
And Throttle and Soft is Throttle and Soft to me, mate. Yeah. It means Throttle and Soft to me, that does.
Well, if you're interested, I couldn't give a damn about your Throttle and Soft.
Oh, I don't suppose you could with a job like that with all your money rolling in, mate. But Throttle and Soft is Throttle and Soft to me. I suppose what's happening is that the postmen are putting their own Throttle pamphlets in their pockets, mate. They're sticking to them. That's what it is. I suppose that's what's happening. They're half-inching them. Anyway, I didn't come about that, mate. I'll come and see what you're going to do about this.
Oh, I can tell you very quickly what we're going to do about that. You're just going to tip it all back up again and take it out of here.
Oh, no, I'm not, mate. You've asked for it and you've got it, mate. And that's all there is, isn't it?
We did not ask for it.
Yes, you did, mate. You've got one of your postmen put this through my door, mate.
Look,
not only that, he's been putting this through for this last 4 weeks. There's two bundles of pamphlets there that I don't want, mate. He's put those through the door. And if he could read, there's a notice on my door which says no pamphlets, no circulars and no bills, mate.
That is not a pamphlet, a bill or a circular.
Well, what is it then?
It's classified mail. The people who asked us to deliver these paid us the money in advance in lieu of postage and we have delivered them classified as mail.
Well, look, to me that, mate, is a pamphlet. It's a pamphlet, bill or circular, mate. That's what is it. And another thing while I'm here, who gave him my name and address?
If you care to look on the back, you'll see there's no address on it. Nobody has written anything, but perhaps you don't bother to read these things. There is no address on that. The people who asked us to deliver these paid the postage in advance and asked us to deliver them to every house in this area.
Oh, did they?
Yes, they did.
Right, well, you've got them all back again.
Well, you can just take them out of here.
Well, I'm not going to take them out of here, mate.
Oh, yes, you are.
Oh, no, I'm not, mate.
If you don't take them out here, I shall have to take some action.
All right, well, take what action you like, mate. I don't want
to... All right, don't say any more. Don't say any more. I shall take the necessary action. I shall call the police.
Hey, just a minute. If you're going to start calling the police...
Yes?
Can I just ask you one question?
Certainly. Ask me anything you like.
Is this a post office?
Oh, don't try and be funny, please. I'm not in the mood for jokes. Of course you know this is a post office.
Oh, well, there you are, then.
What do you mean, there I am, then?
I want to post it.
What a post it?
I want to post it.
Oh, don't be so ridiculous, my good man. Don't start playing jokes at me. I'm no mood for comicalities. Post it? You cannot post all that, send all that junk through the post.
Well, half of it came through the post to me, mate, I'll tell you that.
But you didn't get that tar and that old bike and that hat stand through the post.
No, but somebody else's, though, I'll tell you that.
Oh, no, they're not.
Oh, yes, they are.
Oh, no, they're not.
Oh, they certainly are, mate.
I'll tell you
why. You can't stop me. I know my regulations, mate.
You know your regulations. I have a book of regulations here. I have a guide here. Post Office Guide, 1961, Rules and Regulations, page 38. Postage, ex-parcels, except the Irish Republic. I presume you don't wish to send it to the Irish Republic. Weight size, there we are. Weight, maximum weight for sending a parcel through the post, 22 pounds.
We know that, mate. We've studied that, mate. There's not one bit of that that weighs over 22 pounds. We weighed it this morning before we came here, didn't we, Liz?
Right. Also, nothing sent through the post should be more than 3'6", maximum length.
Well, what's wrong with that, then?
I should think that was slightly more than 3'6".
Liz, you got a saw?
Sure.
Saw that down the middle.
You're determined to send it, aren't you?
I certainly am, mate. I'll tell you that.
Oh, very well, if that's your attitude. I'll soon see. You're going to send it. Charlie, weigh that, will you, please?
19 pounds.
19 pounds.
Weigh that one, will you, Charlie?
20 pounds.
20 pounds.
Put those together and weigh that, will you, please, Charlie?
22 pounds.
22 pounds.
Weigh that, Charlie.
19 pounds.
19 pounds.
One bike. Would you like to weigh that one too, please?
22 pounds.
22 pounds. Oh, well, they're all within the 22-pound limit. This is going to cost you a pretty penny. Now, who do you want to send it to?
The Postmaster General.
The Postmaster General? But you can't send him things through the post that he doesn't want.
Well, he's sending things through the post to me that I don't want, mate.
Hey, just a minute. What about the postage?
Let him pay double the other end. It'll teach him a lesson. Come on, let's get out of here. Go on.
Gonna do now?
I'm gonna raise it. 1,000. I'll see that.
Okay. I see your 1,000. What have you got, Mac?
4 queens.
All right.
Why? You got something to compete that?
Sure have. 4 kings.
Hold it, partner.
Why, have you got something to beat that?
I sure have. I've got 4 aces.
Hold it, Lou.
Why? Have you got something that can beat that?
I sure have.
What have you got?
Thank you very much. We're going to do our slow one now. It's called You Better Move On.
You asked me to give up the hand of the girl I love. You tell me I'm not the man she's worthy of. But who are you to tell her who to love. That's up to her. Yes, and the Lord above. You better move on. Well, I know you can buy her a fancy clothes and diamond rings, but I believe she's happy with me without those things. Still, you beg me to a set of rings, but my friend, that will never be. You better move on. Now, I don't blame you for loving her, but can't you understand, man, she's my girl, and I'm never, never, ever gonna let her go, 'cause I, yeah, I love her so. Well, I think you best of all, now I'm getting mighty mad. You ask me to give up the only love I've ever had. Maybe I would, oh, but I love her so. Never gonna let her go. You better move on. You better move on. You better move on.
I knew that wasn't me if I played that. How much did we get on?
Well, it's not a bad morning. It's not been a bad morning, especially for the quality of the music. But it's a bit mean when you think of a man playing as you're supposed to be playing, and all we get is fitting Satan-y. I know. they're not a musical nation, the British. No, they ain't got the ear for a good tune.
Now, all they think about is the Rolling Stones round here. Yeah. That's what it is. I mean, after all said and done, that was a good bit of fiddle playing, that was.
Oh, yes, oh, it was a lovely bit of playing, especially for a man with only one leg. I know. You think that'd have gone. You think that would go well. I know. It's a mean district, this is.
Well, I'm not limping round here for fighting sake, I'll tell you that, mate. I mean, you'd think we'd have got a bit more out of these people, didn't you?
Yeah.
With the fur coats on, all those fur coats that kept going by.
Yes, I often wonder how they get them myself.
Well, that's obvious, isn't it? I mean, you don't get a fur coat for nothing, do you?
Oh, no, no.
I think you better help me off with this leg, will you?
Yeah, well, take off that hand first, will you? Right.
I think we can knock off till about 4:30. I don't think there's any more violin playing on the BBC, according to the papers, till 4:30.
No, I've been writing in every day to put some on, but they don't appear to put them on anymore.
No, they're supposed to be artistic, aren't they? The wireless is supposed to be artistic. Not a bit like the television. It's always the same.
I had no difference at all, except for the pictures. You see, that's what it is, television without pictures. That's why radio was not so popular. Who wants television without the pictures?
Well, nobody wants to tell you, but that's what they want, mate. Look, that's what they want.
Yes, it's all here. It's all here, indeed. A sirloin steak, a leg of lamb, 4 herrings, 2 pounds of rice, and 4 pints of milk go into 1 tin of puppy cat. Yes, puppy cat. Price 6 pence. Go out, they'll love it. Buy it now. 6 pence. Puppy cat.
I could eat a tin of that myself now, couldn't you?
Yeah, if we had another halfpenny, we could get a tin.
A tin of that, two glasses of Van Rouge, put our berries on, I'll play the violin, we think we're in Montmartre.
Don't be just a man in a crowd, be a special.
Hey, that would be a marvellous idea.
What?
If we was to join the special.
What?
Yeah.
You mean, join the law?
Yeah, well, it's not a bad job. I mean, all you got to do all day is walk around and show old people across crossings. Or tell people the time, that's all you got to do. I mean, we do more walking about than they do now. And don't forget, they got their little cubby holes that they can disappear into and have a little drawn out again, mate. That's apart from the perks, you know.
Perks? What perks?
Well, the bribery and corruption, you know, the old pound notes in the driving licence.
Yeah. Oh, I see what you mean. And if they didn't pay up, you knock them off. Oh, I see, yeah.
Of course you do, and then you get a day off to go down to the court and you watch the beak send them up the river, mate.
Oh, that wouldn't be a bad job. Yes, that'd be a good job, all right.
Just go and volunteer. It wouldn't be a bad job, would it?
Good,
just
yes.
Go and have a go at that.
Yeah.
Volunteer. Come on.
Yes, madam, yes. Yes, all right, madam, yes. Well, all right. Now, don't you worry, don't you worry. We'll get a squad car down there right away. I'll send someone straight over. Now, don't you worry. You just sit tight there. Fine. Goodbye.
Here we are, Sergeant. Get the forms you wanted.
Oh, thank you very much. Noise, don't go for a minute. I've got something here for you. Get a squad car out, will you? And go down and investigate that. I don't, maybe nothing at all, but we'd best look into it.
Far away.
All right. Hello? Oh, yes, sir. Yes? Well, Noise just going out, sir. Well, I'll call him. Just a minute, sir. Noise!
Sergeant!
Call Inspector Chandler's office on the way out. He wants to tell you something.
Far away.
He's just going to come and see you, sir.
Shop!
Yes, good. And what do you two want?
Well, we come in answer to the advert.
What advert?
Well, the advert on the television about the specials.
What about the specials?
Well, we want to join.
What, you and him?
Yeah, me and him.
You're joking.
I'm not joking, mate. I've always wanted to be in the police force, haven't I?
Oh, yes, that's right. And me.
Really?
And we saw the television advert and saw you were short of labour, so we thought we'd come and volunteer.
Well, we may be short. In fact, we are short, but we're not taking any old rubbish.
Hey! I'm not old rubbish. I'm not any old rubbish.
I like the way he says he's not taking any old rubbish. That's marvellous, isn't it? What I've seen in the police force this last few years is nothing else but old rubbish.
You're getting rather cheeky now, aren't you?
Well, you started it, didn't you? I mean, we came in here full of civility, didn't we? Yeah. We wanted offering our service to join it, and all we get is insult.
Yes, well, if you'd just like to take your civility outside...
Yeah, but you're supposed to be a courtesy copper. I read it in the papers. All the coppers are now supposed to be courteous.
Well, on that case, I'm sorry.
Oh, it's a bit too late to say you're sorry, mate. It's a bit too late. I mean, it's all right saying you're sorry to him, but you've hurt his feelings now, mate. I mean, just because he looks like that, it doesn't mean to say he's got no sensitivity, mate. I mean, you're not talking to an animal now. You're not talking to a wild animal now, mate. You're talking to an ordinary human being, as a human being like me and you, mate. I mean, he only dresses like that because he's poor. I mean, he's not dirty through choice, you know.
Have you quite finished?
Yeah, I've finished, and I don't bear any malice, and shake hands on it. Forget it.
Now, will you please
get out?
No,
don't shake hands.
I don't wish to shake...
Nah, come on, shake hands.
Don't do that to me! You can go too far, you know. Now, I've told you, I don't wish to shake hands with you. I haven't got time to mess about with the pair of you. Now, get out. Go on.
Well, I haven't got time to mess about with you. If you just get the forms out, we'll sign them, if you don't mind.
Look, I have told you once before, you cannot join the specials. So
why
get
up. Why can't we join the specials?
We are not looking for types like you. I suppose you're right.
What types are you looking for, then?
Well, put it quite bluntly, you have to pass an intelligence test to join the police force.
Oh, that's a good one. Oh, very good. Pass an intelligence test to join the police. Well, if you have to pass an intelligence test, how did you get in?
You're getting rather cheeky now as well, aren't
you? Yeah, well, you started it, mate. I mean, you're only being big because you've got a sergeant's uniform on, mate. Well, I'll tell you, mate, that me and him fought for our country, mate.
Well, so did I.
Yeah, well, so did we, mate. I'm not saying you didn't.
What's it got to do with the fact that
Well, I'm just saying, if we fought for our country, if we were good enough for fighting for the country, we're good enough to be in the police force.
Yep. And I am saying that you are not.
Well, I'm not talking to you any longer. It's not your police force. It's nothing to do with you. You're only a sergeant. Go and get the boss. Go and get Barlow. Send him out. Come on. Come on, get him out.
Oh, yes. He's nobody. Fluffy, look at that. I wouldn't believe that's a good one, isn't
good
it?
Well, what? Rubbish?
Rubbish.
Oh, I say it's a good one, that is. Yeah, talking about rubbish. Talking about rubbish. What I've seen of the police force, they're taking all shapes and sizes these days.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. What? We're not taking your shape or his size.
Well, what's wrong with his size, then?
Well, he's too little, for one thing.
Well, perhaps he can do a job that a big copper couldn't do.
Such as what?
Well, handling dwarfs.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes, I could handle dwarfs. If they gave any trouble, I could clout them one.
Could you? And if there was any little petty thefts, you could send round a little petty copper.
Sergeant Parsons?
Oh, yes, Brown.
The chief wants to see you.
Oh, I'll be with him in a moment.
Blimey, this job's a bit better than I thought it was. Look.
Oh, yeah. Hey, get down on the night beat with one of them, you'll be all right.
Well, what's she supposed to be handling, then? Who's she handling?
She will handle you two if you don't watch out.
Well, I wouldn't mind that, would
now
you?
Now, look, before you... Before you go any further, I'm going in the other room for a moment, and when I come back, I expect to find the pair of you gone. Understand? Thank you, Brown.
Oh, you see, they'd take her in, and they wouldn't take me in. I could do the same as she can do. That's what happens when they started them suffragettes. I knew it'd end like this.
And like what?
Women doing men's jobs.
Ah, oh, she's not doing a man's job. She's what they call a copper's comfort. Here.
What?
Just in case we're lucky enough to get in, go and put that uniform on, see what you look like in it. Oh, that's marvellous. God, but you know what you could do?
What?
You know what you could do? You could take old PC Steele's place in Zed Car.
Yeah.
They're going to knock him off.
Oh, Constable, you must help me.
Now, I must tell you, madam, that anything you say will be taken down and never seen again.
I beg your pardon. I haven't done anything.
Oh, yes, they all say that.
But I haven't. I've lost my Harold. Oh, my poor Harold, he's lost.
Has he gone?
Yes. You see, he left the house last Monday night, and I haven't seen him since. I'm sure he's lost.
Oh, well, the lost property office is round the corner.
Now, just a minute, madam. Did you say your Harold's been lost?
Yes.
Can you prove this?
Prove it? Well, of course I can prove it. He's not there, is he?
Ah, but because he's not there doesn't mean to say he's been lost. He might have run away, you know.
My Harold run away?
Yeah.
Why should my Harold run away?
Well, have you seen yourself in a mirror lately, madam?
I beg your pardon. Who are you, anyway?
Oh, Chief Inspector Haynes, Special Division, madam.
You?
Yeah, me.
A police officer?
A police officer, yeah.
I don't believe it. They wouldn't have rubbish like you in the force.
Hey, just a minute, madam. You don't want to let these clothes fall, you know. I mean, I've got to wear these to mix with the underdogs, don't I? After all said and done. So I want the facts now, madam, if you don't mind. Can I have the facts? Give me the facts, ma'am. Okay, give me the facts. I want the facts, nothing but the facts. Now, I don't want any sloppy answers. You give me one sloppy answer and I'll run you up the river. Now then, Miss Harold.
How dare you?
Miss Harold, how long have you been living with him?
My Harold is a cat.
Well, why didn't you say it was a cat?
And you want us to find him?
Oh, yes, please, if you will.
Is there any reward for this cat?
Oh, yes. Yes, I'm quite willing to give him £5 for anybody who'll bring him back.
Do you think we could have the reward in advance, then, like?
Oh, yes, certainly, Inspector. Yes, I'll give you my card as well here.
Thank you very much. Take the lady's name and address.
And we'll find him for
oh,
you.
Oh, yes, you don't want to worry about that. Constable Kelly, get the drag nets out and put a roadblock in every corner, will you? Make sure the cat doesn't leave town.
Oh, thank you. Thank you so much.
Oh, that's all right. Well, blimey, we handled that all right, didn't we?
Oh, yeah.
Hey, and he said we hadn't got the intelligence. I reckon 6 weeks here, we doubled their profits, didn't
we? Oh, indeed, we do that all right. We double their profits.
Hold tight, here comes old Big Feet.
You're still here, then?
Oh, yeah.
I thought I told you to get out of it.
Well, we haven't, have we?
Oh, no, we're not going to be signing them forms.
And I've said that you're not signing any forms.
Well, in that case, we're not going to move until we sign the forms.
All right, that's your attitude. Just a minute. Brown! Brown, these two gentlemen refuse to go. Now then, are you going to go quietly or do I have to ask the officer here to throw you out?
Oh, that's a good one. Oh. What does she think she's going to do, eh?
Brown, would you show them what you can do, please?
Certainly, Sergeant.
Oh, God.
Hey, don't you start coming your Avenger stuff with me, Mrs. You're picking on the wrong one here, mate. I used to be in the commando, so watch it.
Really?
Yeah.
Did they ever show you...
Hey! Don't! Oh, blimey. I can tell why she's What's she doing a man's job then,
yeah,
eh?
Oh, she's a man dressed up in woman's clothing. That one.
Well, you could have fooled me. He could have fooled me. That's a wonderful disguise, isn't it?
Hey, do you want to join them special jet?
I don't think so, do you? We got a fiver out of it.
Yeah.
Just go and get a tin of tabby cat.
Ah, yeah.
Puppy cat.